Andreas from Vizlab Studios here. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about how to generate ideas and the benefit of generating ideas. So for this I have made a little idea generator. It looks like this. I'll get right back to it, but first I would just like to say a little bit about why it's really really important to have ideas and why to generate them. Because what I see a lot is that if you generate ideas, like completely blue sky ideas, that you say, I want to create something, but you really don't know what directions you're going in. It's like you have so many open doors that, should I go this way? Is it like, what about this? Oh, that would be interesting. Then you start to explore. So maybe you go this way and explore these possibilities, but that just leads to further questions. And like, is this path you're gonna, like, there's so many possibilities, and before you know it you'll be stunned and paralyzed and you'll probably end up not moving anywhere. I've ended in this situation a lot of times, so I end right back here. Like, I maybe explore a little bit and then, oh shit, I go back to base again. So in a way, to structure your thoughts and to generate ideas out of a template, this is really really beneficial to avoid this chaos of blue sky. Blue sky is a loose term that just says that you have nothing to start with. Basically looks like this. So what am I gonna do? Paint a dragon? Am I gonna paint a mech? Something? I have no idea. So this would probably stun me to just have a blank canvas. So in a way it's the same as introducing a framework for you to work within. So this is really really good. So for this, let me just see if Windows wanna collaborate. Here we go. So for this little demonstration, I just made this. This is really really simple, so let me just get it right into Photoshop so I can paint a bit on top. Oops, make it bigger so that we can read what's going on. So the first thing I did here is just to introduce a where, a when, a location, and a player action. For this demonstration I was thinking that it's going to be a game or location for a game. So think of like maybe an interior shot where you enter a room, something happens. You enter somewhere, in some time, in some location, and then something is going to happen. So you find a chest with something, like you find the diamonds, but then the robot attacks. So this is like sort of the string that you can generate out of this stuff. So for this, this is really really nice, because from this I can say, well, what kind of culture are we, like what do we need to research? Because again, this is really really important when you make a project, that is, you know what to research, because you cannot just always make up like alien civilization that is completely taken out of context with the real world that we live in, because we live in a world that is like filled with so much culture, so much references, and so many things that you really really don't need to make a lot of new stuff. You can basically grab a lot of these free designs that are already made. I'm trying to do some brutalism from Eastern Europe here. I don't know if it really conveys the idea, but I hope it goes through. Anyway, like, a lot of this just tells about what is it that I'm going to research later. Then of course, like, time period. It's like, when are we talking? Is this medieval times? Like, what does it say about technology? Like, the houses that you live in? Lighting situation, like what kind of rooms would you have in that time? What kind of situation are we in? Like, this is a wartime, like people are fighting in this period, so things would look different. It also, like, industries have everything is directed towards war. So this, like, if it was this period of time, they did sort of give me an idea of what to in what direction to point the stuff in. So I just put in a bit of a joker here. So this one is just like, it's so far out in the future that I have no idea what technology would look like. So basically my vision of the future is that we have two directions. Either everything is utopian and we have like ginormous skyscrapers and green cities and everything is in harmony, or basically everything is in ruin and we sort of have to restart civilization Mad Max style. Personal opinion, I don't know. It could be a combination of both, I guess. Then location is just to, like, this is the general location, this is like global scale location, I would say. I'm trying to draw a world map here. This is more like, well, is it taking place in the back alley? Is it at a weapons dealer, a secret monger? So this is like more pinpointed down on that big map and say, we are in this city on this street. Just to get a more clear idea of where we are. And then of course, like a player action, because this is crucial when we design the location. What is it that we're going to do in this location? And this could also be applicable for film or anything, so it doesn't need to be necessarily games. But what is it that we do in this area? So for example, if we need to barricade ourselves, maybe for like a game design point of view, if you have a room, then it would be nice for some for you to have something to hide behind. So is that a thing, like, do you need some boxes and crates? Do you need to push something in front of the door? Is there windows that you can barricade? All these kind of things. If you need a safe place to hide. So all these things can be, like all these needs to be taken into account. So again, like the beneficial thing about having structured like this, sorry, is that you get rid of this blank canvas and blue sky, and just you're forced to sort of follow a string. So it's a great way, it's a great exercise to just get something rolling and just to have something, because then it tells you what to do, basically. So let's just actually get started. Let's just try, and you can't see it, but I promise I'll close my eyes and then I'll just try to pinpoint at what we can make a string out of, and I can just make a first sketch, and then we can talk about what we get out of this one. So I'll close my eyes and I'll make a dot. So we're in a desert. I'll choose a time. 2100. And I'll choose a location. Sounded like a junkyard. And a play action. Looking for hidden objects. Or was it in between? I'll choose again. Boop. Looking for hidden objects. Okay, whatever. So my string is this now. So it's like a node-based system. We're in a desert. We're in the future, but not super far away, actually. We're in a junkyard, and we're looking for a hidden object. So this sounds to me like some sort of quest, like we can make an isometric shot that sort of says something about, like, you have a player, and we have this area that we need to explore, and we have a junkyard, and we need to find some sort of hidden object. I can see, like, maybe it could be fun, because then what is the danger in this place? But maybe there's an NPC that sort of ambushes you, and we have this big ginormous claw up here that is used to grab scrap metal. And then once you find this, that you're looking for this hidden object, then you're getting attacked by this claw, or maybe it's like an automated system that sort of attacks you. So you have this ginormous claw up here that once you find your, let's just mark it with X as a spot, then this guy is gonna attack you. So you walk around and you have to find a way to disable the system. And this is gonna be like a little bit of a miniature environment where everything is a little bit on top of each other. So probably you can make this bigger and smaller, but just I'll try to cram as much story into this as possible. So you'll find whatever you're looking for, then you're being attacked by this claw that is like, it's basically, it leaves a shadow on the ground like 2 seconds before it strikes, so you always know where to run. But then when you run around, you'll all of a sudden see that there's this electrical box over here. So if you run over here, you can pull the plug on this little guy so that it doesn't attack you anymore. So this could be a thing. So what we're looking for, I don't know, maybe we just broke into this, like we're in the future, everything is in ruin, but you broke into this because you need spare parts for something. So whatever you're looking for, maybe we have an empty fridge that is laying down, and whatever part you is looking for is inside this, because then we have a nice box we can have things within, and then maybe it's just some broken gears that you're looking for. So it's fairly easy as a player to say, okay, there's a location that probably I should look into. There's a, like a box, because basically it functions as a frame, and you can make a nice shaded area, a dark area around it, and you have this object poking out into the sunlight. So it makes it easier for the player to not get confused, because if you're looking through a ton of scrap, then you can easily get confused. But if you know exactly where to look, then it's easier. So you have you sneaked over this, or maybe like there's this broken part in the fence that you have snuck in, and then you're looking here. As soon as you touch this object, this claw will start to attack you, and then you have to run over here to pull the plug on this guy. Maybe actually the trick here is that you need to pull the plug when it's down, embedded in the ground. So when it's embedded in the ground, maybe it hits down in the ground. So you have to pull the plug when it's down here, because then you can climb on this. It becomes maybe more like a ladder, and then from there you can climb up and get to another location that you need to go to. So you need to take it out of function as soon as it is down on the ground. So maybe it's an extra quest or something like that. So I mean, this is one idea. So this is just based on the string. I know what to research. I need to look for desert environments. I need to look a bit in the future. What like is the desert environment? Sorry, let me just try to make some lines here. What I was thinking. So desert environment says something about the ground, the whole like the color scheme of everything. Time period says something about the technology, what kind of things are thrown out. So I need to look a bit into the future, like maybe it's a tech junkyard. If you know from Africa, where there's this big junkyards of electronic scraps, so it could be like more tech scrap. Then yeah, of course there's a junkyard, so junkyard says of course something about the whole environment as a whole. So it needs to look like a junkyard, it says right there. And then we're looking for hidden objects, so of course that needs to be right in there. So either maybe the door is closed and you need to open the door. So we can, as a, if it's an isometric shot, we can maybe break this down into that you have this fridge with the door closed, you have the fridge with the door open, and then you have this object in there. So it's easy for whoever has to model this or whatever. Like the idea here is that you pass this knowledge on to the next in the pipeline, and they sort of have to be inspired by what you do. So this is just an idea. These are just ideas, and this is something that could be used by everybody on the team afterwards to generate ideas and more content for the game you do. So this is just one idea. So let's see if we can make something that is even more cool or more original. So again, I'll just move this down here. So let's get it on this red. Close my eyes again. We're in South America. We are in the First World War period. And we have a weapons dealer. Nice. And we need a safe place to sleep. So let's see what we can do with this. It's a bit alternative, but yeah, fine. So this, I'll just move up here again. Again, let's just go with an isometric shot to begin with, just to like establish a location, just to establish ideas. I find it that if you do art like this, where you already have, like you're looking at it from a camera inside a room or something, and you have whatever placement of actors and props and stuff like this, it makes it so much more difficult for me, at least to sort of start to imagine what kind of environment and where are things located and stuff like this. All this you take away when you do this isometric shots, because placement of characters, objects and stuff like that, you don't have to deal with a camera in the scene, because right now this camera would be sort of here and the characters are here talking to each other, and we have whatever box, the television or something here in the background. I know there was no television back then for real, so whatever box, bar cabinet or something, and they're talking to each other here. This is so much easier to understand. This is like really taking all the information and laying it out really, really clear, so that it's easy to understand. So I always recommend setting up stuff like this to place things really, really easy, and then afterwards you can of course start to say, okay, I want a shot where this guy is more like this and the other guy is more like this. Okay, that means that we basically have moved the camera a little bit more this direction. But if you want a shot like I really want to, the first guy to look really, really big and the second guy to look really, really small. But then that just means that we have the camera placed here somewhere, so it shoots in this direction. So all these concerns about camera placement is something that you take away as soon as you have this isometric shot. Really, just go with it. I recommend it a lot. So for this, let's just get rid of all this. Let's redraw this. So let's just start with a square environment. It's really easy to set up. So we have a weapons dealer, but we need to a safe place to sleep. So maybe it's like it's a shop. It's a shop where you come in, but you. Is it a shop? Let me just think. Maybe it's actually like you have this basement, because maybe it's an underground movement that runs gun, and you have this basement. Let me just think. Maybe you're in Argentina. I have no idea if actually the wine industry in Argentina was something, or wine industry in South America was something back in those days. But let me just assume that you have like this Argentinian basement where you have wine barrels, and then it's like a rebel movement, and then you have like maybe a bunk bed here, and you need this place. This is a place where you can rest, but at the same time you have. So it's a weapons dealer, but maybe it could just like be a repair shop. So you have maybe this is where you can go in and repair guns and stuff like this. And this is where there's a guy standing here, and you can come down here and talk to him. He can mod and rearrange guns. So maybe we have like these gun racks standing here with a lot of old rifles. And this is where you can sort of customize and mod whatever you have. So maybe he has some equipment. For this, let me just some workbenches. Maybe he has some more workbenches here that we can work with. So just like, so this area looks like part of this location. It tells something about what is this environment. It's a place, a safe hiding place, but at the same time, it's a place where you can mod, alter, and upgrade your weapons, and then you go out again into like new adventures. So. And then we put a little candle here so that it indicates this is the place to sleep. And more weapons, and maybe you have some racks and hand grenades and stuff like that. So basically it's just now I would go on Wikipedia, on Google, I would start to try to search for location. Is this actually for reals? Like do we have this a basement maybe that would look anything like this? How does the weapons look like back then? What kind of rebellion groups were there active at that time? All these kind of questions that you can answer just by looking, because now I have an outline of an environment that I want to look into, then it's easier for me to start searching for what I want to search. So yeah, that was my second idea. Let's just generate a last idea, and then I'll take one of them to a more finished level. So again, close my eyes. Toot, Eastern Europe. What time? Ah, we have already have it. 1800. Yeah. And abandoned factory. Ooh. And we're scavenging. So, abandoned factory, 1800, Europe. Ah, Eastern Europe, sorry. So again, let me just set up this. Shot. So what kind of factory could it be? Maybe we have, could it be like, maybe we have like a old slaughterhouse, but then if it's an abandoned slaughterhouse, then maybe things wouldn't be like, if we have these carcasses hanging, they would be rotten away. It would be really nice, but maybe we actually, the carcasses is already turned into bones and skin hanging on top of them. So we just have these like nasty, nasty carcasses. So the story for why this is abandoned, again, maybe we just have war broken out. Like one of these unsettled periods of time in Europe where you need to look into what kind of like, what kind of countries were in war with each other at that point of time. So maybe we have this like piles of rotten meat and bones and stuff like that, and you're trying to look for something to eat in here. Maybe you'll get ambushed by some other NPCs that are, this is their place, even though it's nasty. So we could have a lot of like iron pillars that divide the rooms. Maybe we have the tables, like butchery tables here, where this is where the meat is hanging, this is where the meat is then chopped up. So we have a lot of big knives and stuff like that you can then pick up and fight with. So we have this area here where you can, where there's like a meat packing. And then maybe at the end here we have these shelves with canned food, because maybe that's what they do. So they do canned food, and we have this ginormous shelf, and some of the cans are still good. Maybe this has fallen over. So to make this look abandoned, and we'll just have a lot of this moved and like thrown around. So maybe behind here we have somebody hiding behind all these corpses. We have somebody hiding in the dark here, in the shades. And then we have more debris here, and maybe some roof that has collapsed and stuff like that. So this is one idea. I'm not really sure, like, if it's a meat packery, then this might have been already gone to waste and completely gone. But maybe you can just make it like so it's just dry bone hanging. I think this is a nice idea. It could really give off a creepy environment. You have this factory with all these carcasses hanging, drifting in the wind. You have the wind coming in, and then you have all these tables where there's a lot of blood, and we have all these white floor tiles with a lot of splatter and stuff like that. So I guess this could be a really nice environment for some creepy action. You come in here because what your objective is that you need to go this way and find whatever you have here. But as soon as you do that, you'll get rushed from behind. You can then run around here and grab something from the table and then fight back. So this could be one idea. So you're looking for food in an abandoned factory. So I'm still thinking some sort of like factory that produces canned food, because if it's abandoned but you still have to have a possibility to find food that is useful, then I guess it's canned because it can last for a long time. So maybe we have these crates. So this is maybe just a small part of a factory, like a place where they ship out the stuff. And you come in here and you can start to look into some of the crates. So maybe one crate is already open, and then you have this canned food in here that you can then start to grab some and then stash for yourself. And again, I can just reuse this idea. Maybe you have like staircase to upstairs, but under the staircase you have somebody living that will then attack you because you're starting to steal from their environment. So yeah, something like this. So either like butchery, like a slaughterhouse, or a storage facility. So one of these two cases. 1800 East Europe. This is something that I can really easily start to research, like how would a factory look back then? What kind of materials is it built out of? Like, is it brick? Do they have iron? What kind of iron? Because back then, like, everything was riveted together. So this is something I also need to look into, like what kind of, like the iron structure, if I can, I'm trying to think of it now, but the fact is that I always think that I know how things look, but then again, now it looks like an octopus, but then I realize that I don't know anything. So I always, like, this is the first step, this is just an idea, then I need to start to go in and look at like how does things actually look, and then because I have an idea of how things look, but I'm not really really sure. So yeah, research is the next phase right after this one. So we had a desert junkyard, we had this basement in Argentina where you have to, like an arms dealer, and then you have this old factory that we can then delve into. So for the next part of this tutorial, I'm going to pick one of these, and then I'm going to develop it into a full sketch that then we can take into 3D and then finalize to make a full call out for a game or a mood shot for a film or whatever we end up taking it to. So thanks for watching this first one, and I hope you like it, and hope you stay tuned for the second part. Thank you.